Last year when we hunted in Florida, the most unique thing is watching a turkey come to you through white sand and the sun beaming off of them.
Spring down here is something special, and these Osceolas are something special. I like turkeys. I do not discriminate the subspecies or the hybridation of them, and where you kill them and how you kill them and who you kill them with is kind of what it's all about.
Started turkey hunting when I was, I would say, 7 years old. My dad took the time on me. My dad, I mean, there's no telling how many turkeys that he could have killed if he was by himself, but didn't, because his focus was passing it on.
My first turkey hunting memories. My first turkey was probably one of the more memorable days of my life. This is my dad and I, who was taking me a couple times. I was 7 years old, I believe. Kind of as my feet dangled over the turkey, I remember him just saying, you know, you're a turkey hunter for the rest of your life, and, you know, that he loved me, he was proud of me, and I don't think I realized at that time, you know, what that phrase meant. You know, you're a turkey hunter for the rest of your life. He was kind of welcoming me into it, and it wasn't long after that I realized you don't just kill one turkey and that's it, and today's a good day. You just signed up for a lifelong journey, and that was a big day. That was day one of, I don't know how many God will let me have, but that was day one at least.
Me and Hunter have been, say, best friends since you could describe a best friend, or you know the meaning of it, but there's actually pictures of us together at, I believe it's his third birthday party. That's how far we go back.
He was always kind of my turkey hunting friend. A lot of my other friends did go turkey hunting, but if I was gonna go with a friend, it was gonna be Austin.
There was never anybody that was as serious as we were. You get juniors and seniors in high school, the weekends, Friday night, Saturday night, you're partying, doing whatever out late, and that wasn't us. We were at home Friday night asleep, getting up at 5 o'clock Saturday morning, going hunting. Telling you, tomorrow I'm gonna swan dive on it. Yeah. I'm gonna shoot and run and just dive. Spring Legion is a brand that simply just is trying to keep the old ways alive.
Believing that turkey hunters are different, and that's something we're celebrating. They are cut from a different cloth. Yeah, when spring comes around, you know, turkey hunters get different real quick. They flip a switch. I just wanted something to represent that.
Sitting there before work one morning, I could tell that whole morning that Hunter's wheels were spinning in his head. He said, I got to talk to you about something. I said, okay. He said, I think we ought to start a brand. He said, we'll make hats and shirts, and we're going to brand a philosophy.
Spring Legion's a logo and some letters to me, because it's not necessarily the brand. It's representing the brand of people more than anything. It's been a pleasant surprise to see how many people are in that community. I think there's a lot more people that are kind of cut from the same cloth that I am that I realized at the beginning. I think it's important for turkey hunters to, you know, be very engaged and very, very involved with today's media outlets and social networks and stuff like that. Because if they're not, somebody will be, and that's kind of what I got a little bit scared of. Is I try to stay a step ahead in terms of things like that, and that's something that I want to make sure we're able to do is to respect the bird, respect the turkey that has provided so much adrenaline and nourishment and opportunity and experience to turkey hunters, that he's worth respecting and worth putting a good light upon. The place we're staying is awesome. I don't know who the landscaper is, but they do a dang good job too. A pretty cool country down here.
Just with turkey camp, just getting to see just different ways of seeing how people do it. It can more so make you understand why he does it this way rather than seeing it on Instagram or Facebook. Something about that face-to-face, one-on-one talk, in my opinion, is better for everybody in hunting, because it's not a finger point, it's not a stepping on toes, it's just a discussion.
I like all turkey hunters. I have stories to relate to every single one of them, I feel like. I just like being in the spring woods.
Hopefully one day I have grandkids that I would like to share that same experience and memories that I have with my granddad. Coming up turkey hunting with him and my dad, I would like to share that with my kids and my grandkids and have the resources to do it. You can't take it for granted and take it away from the next generation. They deserve the right to be able to enjoy and appreciate it the same way you do.
It's very important for those who love the turkey hunt to want to protect what they love, being the wild turkey, through, you know, organizations like the NWTF. And I think, in my mind, it's the least you can do. I think if every turkey hunter, if everybody who likes the turkey hunt or just does it a time or two, it's worth your while to become a member. You know, when it comes down to organizations and the research and the projects that they're able to conduct, I think that's where my dollar's best utilized.
The challenge and the reward, the feeling you have when it does work out, that you beat the bird, that you did it, and can't wait to go again.
And there's just something different about the springtime. I think that's really what I love about turkey hunting, is being out in the spring woods. I always relate that back to those memories of my dad and camouflage, you know, turkey vest, boots, all that. There's an evolution to all that. All that stuff changes, but like, that bird doesn't change. That bird sounded like that in the 40s. It's gonna sound like that when my kids are my age. And being able to experience that is very special. This is an experience in itself, and if you blink, you miss it.